Okay, welcome back. Welcome back to the next session on microcontroller and embedded system laboratory. Now discuss the next experiment, that is the sixth experiment. Write a program to find largest or smallest number in an array of 32-bit number. Okay, now what are the, how many variables are required for this to find the largest or smallest number? First start with largest number, then we'll go for the smallest number. Okay, now how many variables are required for this? So we need one array where all 32-bit numbers are required. Then in that array, how many elements are there? Nothing but count of that array element, and one more variable to store the number, so that after finding largest or smallest number. Okay, so need three variables. Okay, now come back to the program part. I can observe that this is the your main program, so I entry and stop only indicated. The in between that will write the programming. Okay, now here the two variables I have declared in the ROM. Okay, one is count, as how many numbers are, or how many number from how many numbers we are finding largest or smallest number. Then this is the array, so where to find the smallest or largest number. So first we start with the smallest one. So exactly opposite will work for the largest one. Okay, so here I am using 32-bit numbers. So 6 32-bit numbers are there, like 2, so 8 2s, 8 5s, 8 1s, 8 6, 8 3s, 8 4s. Okay, from this we have to find the smallest number. Okay, after finding that, we need to store the result at variable name result. Okay, all these R variable are 32-bit DCD, defined constant double word. Okay, all these are. Okay, now you can change the variable name also according to your convenience. Okay, now how to find it, what logic you can apply it. Okay, for that, now look at the these six numbers. Okay, now nothing but we need to compare the first each number with all rest all numbers and find out that which one is the smallest one. For example, now this 8 2s I'll compare with the 8 5s. After comparing this, I'll come to know that the 8 2s is smallest one. Okay, first I'll explaining about the smallest one. Okay, later on come to the largest one. After comparing that, so I'll keep somewhere this 22 in some register. Let assume that I'll keep it in the R2. Let assume that right now. Okay, now after comparing this R2 content with 8 5s, I'll know that the 8 2s are smallest one. Okay, then I'll compare this R2 content where smallest number, will compare with the next number. Okay, similarly now after comparing, I'll come to know that 8 1s is smallest one. Again copy back that into the R2. So nothing but R2 holds the smallest number. Okay, now after that getting the smallest number, now again compare the content of R2 with the next number, that is 8 6. So after comparing these two, I come to know that 8 1s is smaller than the 8 6. So again the content of R2 will not be changed. Now next one will compare with the next number. Now next R2 content will compare with the R3. Okay, now again I'll come to know that 8 1s are smaller than the 8 3s. So keep remain as it is and check for the next number. Okay, so again I'll come to know that the 8 1s is smaller than the 8 4s. So there is no change in the content of R2. The content of R2 change only when, if you find the content of R2 is smaller than or larger than any other number, then only you have to change it. Okay, in case of smaller, if you find any number which is larger than R2, that should be content of R2 get replaced by that number. So how many comparison you have done it? 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, no, sorry, this one is not there. So I have done five comparisons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll think of that. If you start compare the first number with the zero, so what will happen then? Of course, zero is the always smallest number. So we'll not get any smallest number from your given array of list. So that's why alpha does not, don't start with the number comparing with the zero. So first compare, first get the first number, that you compare with the next number. From that you get the smallest one. Okay, same thing, smallest number compared with the third number. Similarly, fourth, fifth, sixth, in between that, if you find smallest number, then replace that content of R2 with the smallest number. Okay, now look at one program. Now, first start with the count. So count is required to how many comparison I'm doing it. So as the six numbers are there, so I need only five comparison. So first I load the R0 by count and subtract the count by one. So reason is that I need only five comparisons. Okay. Then after the, now you have now six count, now you have the subtracted by one, now five. Now I need to compare the five times. Okay. So first get the first number now. So with the help of, so to get the first number, we need pointer to point to this variable array. So we'll use the R1 as a pointer. Okay. LDR R1 comma equal to array. Okay. Now LDR will point to the R1 will point to the R1 will point to the array. Okay. Now next one. Next one. Now after pointing it, now get that value. So what value is stored in the alpha? Get the first element into the register R2. So we can use LDR R2 comma in square bracket R1. Okay. Now I have copied the first number into the R2. Okay. And R2, I'll make sure that it always holds the smallest number. Okay. After comparison. Now I'll get the next number, that is 5 8s. I am not comparing with zero. I'll repeat once again. I am comparing with first number with the second number. Okay. So I'll get the second number by using LDR R3 in square bracket R1 comma hash 4. So why I use the hash 4 here? R1 is right now is pointing at this R1 is pointing at this first element. If we add 4, so nothing but the, it will point to the next element, because you are working with the 32 bit number. That's why I've added the 4. Okay. Now I'll use the compare statement. Compare. Keep in mind that your R2 are comparing with the R3, not R3 with R2. Make sure that, because this will decide that where to store the smallest number or where to store the largest number. Right now I'm discussing on the smallest one. Then after comparing, I'll use the, because it is going to, comparison usually affects on the CPSR. It affects carry flag, zero flag, sign flag. So how we can, now we need to check that whether it is smallest or not. Okay. If the content of R2 is smaller than the content of R3, then no need to change the content of R2. So what I'll do it, branch if lower, then check the next number. Using the branch instruction BLO, branch if lower, that indicate that content of R2 is lower than content of R3, or content of R2 is smaller than content of R3. Okay. Now there is no change in the R2. Okay. If the condition fails, later on come to the label name next part. Okay. If the condition fails, nothing but the content of R2 is not smaller than R3, is indicate that content of R3 is smaller than R2. So we need to copy the content of R3 to the content of, or to the resistor R2. So if condition fails, so I have to use simple move R2 comma R3 if condition fails. Okay, fails indicate that the content of R2 is larger than or greater than content of R3. Okay, if the condition BLO fails. Okay, then now come to the label next. If the condition satisfies, I'll come back here again. If condition satisfies BLO, so compare the content of R2 with the next number, that is 0, that is 8 ones. Or do I compare 8 twos with 8 fives? So I'll know that this is one is the smallest one. Okay, so there is no change in the R2. Okay. Now, if there is no change in the R2, now you have to need to check with the next number. So next number thing, but your pointer should increment and point to the next number. Okay, here, next number, that is this. So what you have to do it, your pointer is nothing but your R1 is pointing to the resistor R1. So your resistor is right now where it pointing, whether it is pointing at first number or whether it pointing at second number. Okay, so look there's these two number. Okay, now here this indicate that we are pointing at first number, this is at pointing at the second number. So this is which type of indexing method, whether it is pre-indexing with write back or only pre-indexing or post-indexing. Post-indexing, it's because the number is already in the bracket, so it is either pre-indexing with write back or post-index, pre-indexing, only pre-indexing. Okay, right now there is no absence of explanatory symbol, so it indicates that only pre-indexing. You know that pre-indexing does not update the base resistor. Here this does not update your resistor R1. So it should update R1, nothing but the pointer now pointing at only at still at first number, still at not ready to point to the next number. This next number, it will access the next number element by adding 4, but there is no change in the content of R1. What you saw in the working of in indexing methods. Okay, so to update your pointer, so we'll use the explanatory symbol here. So explanatory symbol indicate that it not only copied the information, also pointer will update it. Now pointer, right now pointer updating at this second number. Okay, so what we have to do right now, it's pointing at this. Okay, now we need to pointer should move to this next number. So how we can do that one? Okay, so before that, now how many comparison are done before pointer moving to the third element? How many comparison are done? Now one comparison I have done it. Out of 5, one comparison I have done it. So we need to subtract S. Why you are using subtract S? You should update your CPSR. R0, R0, #1. Subtract it by 1. Then after subtraction, check the content of R0 is 0 or not. Yes, right now it is not 0 because we have subtracted only once. So after 5 minus 1, it will not become 4. So still 4 comparisons are required. Still 4 numbers are there. You can observe that. Still these 4 numbers are there. We need to compare it. So what I'll do it will branch if not equal. So back. So I'll use the keyword back. So where I have to write this back label? I have to write this back label in front of this pre-indexing with write back, which will add 4 again because right now it pointing at this number. So again it add 4, so of course the R1 will point to the next number. So this next number compare with the content of R2. You can observe that content of R2, the next number is will bring into the R3, that will compare with the R2. R2 right now content is 8 ones, that will compare with the R3 where 8 content of R2 is 8 twos are there and content of R3 is 8 ones. Okay, then the condition BLO get fails because the content of R2 is not smaller than or lower than the R3, so we need to replace the content of R2 by R3. Now R2 is become 8 ones. Now after that we subtract 1. Now out of 4, 2 comparison are done it. Out of 5, 2 comparison are done. No, 3 comparison are remaining. So next, these are remaining. Okay, then branch if not equal, then the branch if not equal meaning is that content of R0 is 0 or not. If not 0, go back to check and next number. Now next number will compare with the 86, that is compare with the 8 ones. Of course the branch if lower get pass and move to the label name next, subtracted by 1. Now I done the 3 comparison, now only 2 comparison number remaining, okay, out of 5. Then we'll come back here again, 8 threes compare with the 8 ones, again condition pass, then move on to next number, compare it, that is 8 fours will compare with 8 ones, then R0 becomes 0, then branch if not equal get failed and it will execute the next instruction. After all comparison, your result is available in the R2, because R2 is used to hold it your smallest number. Okay, now I got the result. Now we need to copy that result into the your variable name result. Here is the variable name result in the RAM. Okay, so we can copy, get the address of the result variable into the next register R4 comma equal result. Okay, then after that we'll have to store it. Now for register to memory, so we have to use the store, str R2 comma in square bracket R4. After that you have to stop your execution, because already you have copied the smallest number in the variable result. Okay. Now I'll save this, then translate this one, so there is no error, no warning, build, rebuild, then debug it. Now you can observe that in this is your memory, one is RAM, memory 1 is ROM and memory 2 is RAM. Okay, now here all your numbers are stored here. You can observe that 111222 here. I can observe that here. This is how many numbers are there. Address is 34, because this is assigned by Kyle compiler, and these are all these from here 38 onwards. These are all your 32 bit numbers are there. Okay, from this 6 32 bit numbers you are finding which one is the smallest one. Okay, that you are copying to the your RAM look to the RAM. Okay, is right now it is 000. Now I'll execute step by step. Now R06, because your count is 6 here, you can observe that count is 6. Then subtract it by 1, because as we need 5 comparisons, we are not comparing with the 0. We are comparing the first number with the rest all numbers. So that's why we need 5 comparisons. Next one, R1 should point to the address of array, which is 38. We can observe that here, which is 38. Here it is 38. This is 38. Okay, this is pointed by R1. Okay, now now next one, now load the memory pointed by R1 to the register R2, that is 8 2s are copied here. You can observe that the 8 2s are copied, this 8 2s are copied to R2. Okay, now next number is copied into the R3, okay. That is 8 5s. So 8 5s are copied into the R3, so next number. So now these two we are comparing, R2 with the R3. Okay, now I'll compare this one. Next one is comparer. Okay, compare it will come to know that it lower. With the help of CPSR, you can observe that it does not affect carry flag, even only affected negative flag. There is no carry flag is affected. So it indicates that R2 content is smaller than R3. Okay. So there is no change in the R2. So it move to the, to check the compare the next number. So we have done the comparison. So with the R0 must subtract by 1, so it become 4. We can observe that. So still it is not 0. So branch if not equal meaning is still the R0 is not 0. So go back to the label name. Back. You can observe that. If you can observe that, it will go back here now. Because R0 is still not 0. It's 4. So still 4 numbers are need to compare it. Okay. Now carefully observe that. Now it will point to the next address. That is address. We can observe that here. R1 content, we can observe that it will pointing to the next number. That is 8 ones. That you are comparing with the 8 twos, which is already there in the R2. Okay. After comparing, it will come to the branch if lower. It affects the carry flag, but you can observe that here. Because R2 is now smaller than the, sorry, R2 is now larger than the content of R3. R3 is 8 ones and R2 is 8 twos. Okay. Now we need to replace the content of R2 by content of R3 by using the move instruction. Now you can observe that it will not go to the label name next, it will go to the instruction move R2, R3. You can observe that here. Yes, here. Move R2, R3. Okay. Now I'll again go to the next step. So that R2 is get replaced by 8 ones. You can observe here also. You can observe here. Okay, better, I'll round up this one. You can observe it here. R2 is now already 8 twos get replaced by 8 ones. Yes, now it replaced because we found the smallest number compared to the 8 twos. Okay. I'll move on to the next one. Now two comparison are done it. So R0 must subtract it by 1, 3. Now remaining 3 comparisons are there, we need to compare remaining 3 numbers. Remaining 3 numbers are there, we need to compare it. Okay. Now R1 will get the, now R1 will get the point to the 40 now, right now. Okay. Now I'll move on to the next one. Next step, now it become 44. And even it will copy the next number, that is 86. Yeah. Now I compare with the 8 fives, 8 ones, then now 86. Now here, this 44 in the R1. Sorry, this 44 in the R1. And the content is, that is 86 is copied into the R3. Okay. Now move on to next. Next step is to, there is no need of replacing content of R2 because it is already, it is smaller. Move on to next. R0 subtracted by, now only 2 numbers are remaining, that is 8 threes and 8 fours are remaining, need to compare it. Move on to next step. Now R1 will point to the address of 8 threes, which is copied in R3. Now still there is no change in the R2. Again now R0 subtracted by 1, now only 1 remaining, that is 8 fours, that bring into the R3. You can observe that R3 is now become 8 fours, that you compare with the R2, still because R2 is now smaller than the content of R3, there is no change in the R2. Now you have completed all comparisons. Okay, now I compared all the numbers. Now you got the smallest number which is available in register R2. You can observe that here. So this value we have to copy to the variable result. Okay, this you have to copy it. So with the help of these two instruction, we'll copy that into the variable register, variable name result. Okay, first bring that result variable address into R4, then you can copy with the help of store instruction. Okay, now you can come to know that. Now look at the content of R4. It's a 4 7 zeros, which is address of your RAM. Right now it's showing 00. You can carefully observe that these two locations, it's showing that 00. Now I'll execute the store instruction, that will replace by 8 ones. Okay, nothing but now you got the smallest number. Okay, so this is the way you have to execute the program. Okay, and find the smallest number. Okay, now this we can work for any other numbers. Okay, now here I use the simple numbers are used. You can mix up any other numbers also. I'll use the instead of as these are all number hexadecimal, I'll use the hexadecimal numbers also. I can use it and use the DDDDD. Then I'll make this to E. Then I'll make this to FFF. You can mix up any character also, no problem in that. Okay. This is another example. Okay. This is another example where from this you have to find the which is the smallest one. I'll save this, translate, compile. So debug, build, rebuild, then click on debug. Now we can observe that here all numbers are stored here. A, B, 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 D, 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 D are stored, A are stored. Okay, you can observe that here all these are stored here. Okay, again six numbers are there. From these six numbers I have to find the which is the smallest one. And directly let's run this one and stop it. We get the smallest number that is in available in R2, that is 8 A's that already copied in the RAM. Okay, that already copied here. We can observe that. Okay, this we can this is the program to find the smallest number. Now how we can do for largest number? Okay, go back. Now branch if lower is used to find the smallest number. So which instruction we can use, replace that by, so we can find the number for largest, which instruction have to use. Okay, so I'll go back to your instruction second module. So branch if I'll go to the list of branch instruction. Conditional branch instruction. Okay, now we can observe that here. Now where is the BLO higher? BLO branch if lower. Now need branch if higher. Where it is? Where it is? Greater, lesser, higher? Here BHI. Okay, as you are working with unsigned number. Okay, because in the aim they are not mentioned that whether you are working with the, whether you have to use signed number or unsigned number. Better use what the. Better go for unsigned number, it become much easier. Okay, now I'll replace that BLO by BHI, so we'll get the largest number. Okay, I'll go back to the program. I'll replace BL by BHI. Save this, translate, build, rebuild, debug. Now directly run this one. Now check the content of R2. It is now 8 F's also stored in the RAM also. Okay, but the 8 F's indicate that, 8 F's indicate that that is more largest number compared to the 8 A's, 8 B's, 8 C's, 8 F's, 8 E's, 8 D's. So 8 F's is largest compared to this. Okay, same thing we can apply for any other numbers. So in general, in journal, so you have to write the, these are all your inputs, and this is your output. So you have to write two set of results, So here in result place, known you have to write the which is the smallest number and which is the largest number. Don't write zero here. Okay. So this selected part we can use to write the result. Okay. Next, in next session we look at the next experiment, that is write program to arrange a series of 32-bit number in ascending or descending number. Okay. Thank you.